So finally the day has arrived where we can see the Starhopper doing an untethered hopping test for the first time.
And then Elon gave an interview to Time magazine hinting at possible Starship missions to the moon as early as 2021. And now suddenly, the design architecture of Starship seems to be changing again from liquid methane bleeding to good old classic heat shield tiles. Also, India's first moon mission launch was a success, and Chandrayaan 2 is now on its way to the moon!
Then we also have a successful cargo resupply mission with a cargo drag module to the ISS, and the Chinese Tiangong 2 space station burned up under controlled circumstances over the South Pacific Ocean, as 100% accurately depicted in this movie here. So stay tuned for these news and more.
Let's start right away with the first successful untethered hopping test of the Starhopper. After the first hopping attempt 2 days earlier had to be cancelled because there was again an unexpected fiery event, we could finally see the first successful untethered hopping in the morning hours on the 26th of July in Boca Chica, Texas. The hopper is a bit difficult to spot because of exhaust clouds, but at one moment, we can see the hopper peer through above the clouds and moving sideways. The reached height must have been around 20 meters, else we wouldn't have been able to see the hopper at all.
The whole test didn't last very long, but it was successful, paving the way for the next untethered hopping tests, which will go even higher than the first hopping test. Elon indicated that the next tests could go as high as 200 meters. It will be quite similar to the grasshopper tests, but of course with a much bigger vessel, so it will be quite awe-inspiring to see the Starhopper rise to 200 meters. And talking about Starship and Starhopper, Elon just recently had an interview with Time magazine, which was quite interesting. In this interview, Elon expresses his frustration with NASA and basically says what Jishwan and me were guessing all the time, that it is highly likely that we will see a Starship land on the moon way before NASA lands on the moon again.
So Elon thinks that at the moment, NASA is completely ignoring Starship, as if it wouldn't exist. And he went on to say that it will probably be much easier to just do everything on their own. So to land Starship on the moon completely on their own than to convince NASA. And take a listen to this excerpt from the interview.
Well, this is gonna sound pretty crazy, but we're certainly with an uncrewed vehicle, I believe we could land on the moon in 2 years.
I believe we could land on the moon in 2 years. 2 years. 2 years.
Okay, of course we know this is Elon time, but nonetheless, it's realistic to assume that an uncrewed version of Starship could land on the moon by late 2021 as sort of a demonstration mission. The Starship orbital prototypes are slated to do the first orbital tests by late 2020, so there is a reasonable chance that by 2021, an unmanned Starship could land on the moon. He also implied that a manned landing could take place 2 years later. So in 2023, 1 year prior to NASA's planned Artemis moon landing date. Now a key to this will be that the building costs of Starship will be quite lower than initially thought. As Elon said in a tweet, they could be lower than those of Falcon 9. Thus, building Starship might be entirely financed by classical investment grants, without need for additional money. Man, if I had 1 billion lying around.
And we shouldn't forget the revenue from Starlink when it goes online in 2021, because it will generate lots of revenue. And by the way, nice coincidence there with 2021. So it would be so funny to see SpaceX just circumvent NASA entirely and land their own people on the moon in 2023 with Starship instead of the Artemis approach. As we all know, Yuzaku Mitsawa's Dearmoon mission is also slated for 2023 for a round trip around the moon, and I think this is not coincidence. 2023 might be the date where we see the first trip around the moon, probably in early 2023, and then a manned moon landing in late 2023. And then NASA would be forced to abandon the SLS Orion and Gateway system architecture and fully switch to Starship, and basically make a contract with SpaceX to only employ Starship for future manned missions to the moon and later on Mars. Now, if that would happen, that would be amazing. In many ways, first we would get a moon base pretty fast, but the second thing is SpaceX would have lots of revenue from different income streams, Starlink, investment rounds, NASA contract, and that would give SpaceX insane funds to progress further with the Mars colonization plan. So it is so cool and awesome and important that Elon is basically reiterating what we were saying on this channel all the time, that we will see a Starship land on the moon in the very near future. And an unmanned landing in 2021 would be absolutely amazing. It would be the ultimate validation test for Starship, basically.
Also related to Starship is the news that SpaceX might be moving away from the liquid methane bleeding hole for the atmospheric re-entry of Starship and instead go for classical heat shield ties. Probably in tests, SpaceX found out that the liquid methane bleeding is not practical after all, and the classical heat shield ties are more cost-effective and also easier. The first ties to be used on Starship are actually being tested on the Cargo Dragon CRS-18 mission to the ISS that is taking place right now. We can see here the heat shield ties that will be used on Starship. We will certainly learn more on Elon's Starship presentation that will hopefully take place soon.
Which basically brings us directly to the next topic, the Cargo Resupply Mission CRM-18 to the ISS. The Falcon 9 booster that delivers the Cargo Dragon to the ISS lifted off at 6:01 p.m. Eastern Time on Thursday, July 25th from Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. Everything went flawlessly and the Falcon 9 booster landed on land again 8.5 minutes after it started. So after a travel time of 2 days, the Cargo Dragon arrived and docked to the ISS, and then it will re-enter the atmosphere again and test these interesting new Starship heat shield tiles.
That same week, India launched their Chandrayaan 2 moon mission on the 22nd of July. Everything went flawlessly, and the probe is currently orbiting Earth in a very unusual orbit. Slowly getting away from Earth in more elongated elliptical orbits, until at some point in early to mid-September, it will enter the moon orbit. Then the lander will detach and land together with a small rover at the lunar south pole in order to find water ice for possible future manned lunar bases. A truly amazing mission, and we are glad to see that more and more nations are pushing for the moon.
And now over to our Chinese friends. The small Tiangong 2 space station entered the atmosphere under controlled circumstances on July 19th and burned up over the South Pacific Ocean. This was, by the way, 100% accurately depicted in this movie here. And we just hope Sandra has made it out alive. This small space station had been in orbit since September 15th, 2016, so almost 3 years. Two taikonauts successfully spent 30 days in orbit on this space station, docking there in October 2016 with their Shenzhou 11 spacecraft. But this hasn't been China's last space station, actually far from it. They are planning on building an even larger space station and having it fully functional and operational for the year 2022. After the retirement of the ISS in 2024, China will be the only nation with a space station. Just think about this for a moment.
So the most amazing piece of news for me is for sure that Elon Musk is contemplating an unmanned moon mission with Starship already in 2021 and a manned mission just 2 years later. So well, do you think that they will make it in time as he proposed?
I think this could be actually quite a realistic prediction. It's not over the top considering how fast progress is going now with Starhopper and Starship. They will certainly be faster than NASA, because NASA, let's be honest, will never really probably reach the moon with SLS, Orion and Gateway.
So would you call it a new space race between NASA and SpaceX?
It is kind of a space race, but more a space race between private companies somehow. And then SpaceX itself is also having a space race of their own between the two rivaling teams in Boca Chica and one in Cocoa, Florida. So that's also another space race within SpaceX. So everyone is racing. Everyone is racing against the other, right?
Kind of true. So we are really living an amazing time for space flight. Maybe we are revived Apollo era again.
It will be even better than Apollo, because this time we will build bases on the Moon and Mars.
True.
And stay there.
Anyway, we will always keep you updated on any new developments. So be sure to subscribe and turn on that bell. See you in next video.